This is second lecture on operational amplifiers. Before we start discussing about inverting and non-inverting amplifiers, let me introduce the concept of differential mode gain and common mode gain. That is a very much important concept for an operational amplifier. Okay. As you know that for an operational amplifier, if it is an ideal one, then the output voltage V naught can be related with the input voltage V 1 and V 2 as follows. Okay. V naught equal to AID V 2 minus V 1, where AID is the open loop gain. Earlier I was writing A, but now I have written here AID, it is because of a specific purpose. Okay, that becomes clear shortly. Now let us consider that V 2 is equal to V 1. Okay, then what will happen? If V 2 is equal to V 1, it is very clear that the output voltage becomes 0, okay, even if the gain is very high. Okay. But this is true for a practical, for an ideal operational amplifier only. Okay. If the operational amplifier is not an ideal one, then even if V 2 is equal to V 1, there will be, there may be a small V naught present at the output terminal. Okay. Why it happens? It happens because of the common mode signal present at the two input terminals. Okay. Let me elaborate this. A general expression for V naught would be V naught equal to AID, which is differential mode gain, into VID, which is differential input, plus ACM, the common mode gain, into VICM, the common mode input. Okay. This is more general expression for the output input relationship for a differential amplifier, where this VID is V 2 minus V 1. And VICM, that is the common mode input voltage, is given as half of V 2 plus V 1. Okay. This is small V 2 plus small V 1. So, now you can see that even if VID is 0 because of V 2 equal to V 1, this VICM remains non-zero. And although this ACM is very small, okay, but you will have an output voltage V naught in this case. Okay. Is it clear? It is because of the common mode gain ACM and the common mode input signal present at the two input terminal, this output becomes, I mean, there will be some output at the pin number 6 of operational amplifier. Okay. So, this V 1 and V 2 can also be written just like here I have written VICM equal to half V 2 plus V 1. I can write here VID equal to V 2 minus V 1, and from these two equations you can write down V 2 and V 1 in term of common mode signal and differential mode signal, okay, VICM and VID. Is it clear? Okay. Now, one more thing I would like to you to notice here is, if I take a situation where V 2 is equal to V 1 equal to, let us say, that 1 volt. Okay. 1 volt, let us say that this is peak of this V 2 and V 1. Okay, just consider that this is DC signal for simplification of for the simple analysis. So, if V 2 is V 1 equal to 1 volt, then in that case you will see that V I D becomes 0, but V I C M, the common mode signal, is equal to 1, I mean half into 1 plus 1, that is 1 volt. Okay. So it's obvious here that even you apply the same input voltage at the two input terminals, okay, the common mode signal will always be present, and the magnitude of that common mode signal is actually 1 volt, not 0, okay. And when this common mode signal goes to 0, if I consider that V2 equal to minus V1, if I say that V2 equal to 1 volt and V1 equal to minus 1 volt, then in that case the common mode parts become 0 and differential mode part becomes 2 volt, okay. So in practice basically we are not going to apply differential input voltage or common mode input voltage, okay. We are going to apply a voltage like 3 volt and 2 volt, okay. So when I apply 3 volt and 2 volt to two input terminals, simultaneously both differential mode signal as well as common mode signal remain present at the input terminals, okay. But ideally, as I have told you, this ACM should close to 0, okay. For an ideal amplifier, it becomes, it is almost equal to 0, ACM equal to 0, and if ACM equal to 0, then basically this differential operational amplifier rejects the common mode signal, okay. So this property is called common mode rejection property, because it rejects the identical signals which are present at the two input terminals, okay. So if ACM is 0, ACM 0 means this operational amplifier has a common mode rejection property. Okay. And this operational amplifier is characterized by a parameter that is called common mode rejection ratio. In short, we call it CMRR, common mode rejection ratio, and it is defined as 20 log the differential gain AID divided by the common mode gain ACM, okay. That means in ideal case this common mode rejection ratio has to be infinity, okay, because ACM is 0. Since ACM is 0, in ideal case the CMRR should be very high, it should be towards infinity. But for a practical operational amplifier like IC741, the typical value for this CMRR to be 75 dB, okay. This is typical value for CMRR, okay. CMRR high means the differential amplifier amplifies the difference of the two input signal, but the rejects the common part of the two input signal, common part of the two input signals, okay. The name operational amplifier, it is built using a differential amplifier. So differential amplifier means it has to sense the difference of the two input only, okay. Whatever the common in the two inputs are to be rejected, okay. Ideally it should be infinity, but in practical case we get CMRR as high as around 75 dB for IC741, okay. After this discussion we shall talk about the non-inverting amplifier first, then we shall talk about non-inverting amplifier. So let us talk about inverting amplifier first. As I have told you that because of very high gain of the operational amplifier, we cannot use that as it is for the amplification purpose, okay. So we actually modify the circuitry using some external components, and one of the possible configuration for the amplifier is something like this. What we do here, we ground the non-inverting terminal, okay, but we use the inverting terminal here. We connect two resistors R with resistance value R1 and R2 respectively, like this. V0, this is our output voltage, R1, if it is R1, it is R2, and the input signal which has to be amplified here has to be connected here, okay. But please note here that this VI is not a differential signal, okay. It is an ordinary signal which is applied between this non-inverting terminal and the ground, okay. If it applied between this minus and plus terminal, then it would be a differential input signal, okay. But since it is applied between the inverting terminal and the ground, it is an ordinary signal which may be a sinusoidal signal, something like this, okay. Let us say that amplitude of this signal is A and its frequency is F, okay. This signal has to be amplified. Let me tell you how this circuit is going to amplify, how this circuit is going to provide a practical voltage gain for this input signal, okay. So, before analyzing this circuit, let me recall the concept of virtual short, which I discussed in the previous class. I told you that if the operational amplifier is an ideal one, then in that case we write it like this, V0 equal to, since A is here open loop gain, A into V2 minus V1, and that equation can be rearranged in this manner, V0 by A equal to V2 minus V1, okay. So, since A is infinity or tending towards infinity, this term becomes very small, 0, and that leads to this V2 equal to V1, okay. And if I manage to put this V2 at 0, then the V1 is also to be 0 because of this virtual short condition, okay. This is in fact called virtual ground, because one of the terminal, this positive terminal, is grounded, okay. This terminal is not grounded, but because this is having, this is at 0 potential, the potential at this node has to be 0, okay. So, this is not grounded directly physically, but it, this node will behave like a grounded node, okay. That means potential here becomes 0 volt. Is it clear? This is called virtual ground concept in operational amplifier. Virtual ground concept, okay. No physical grounding, but still that node behaves like a grounded point, okay. Potential becomes 0. And to analyze this circuit, you need to know one more important property of the operational amplifier, that is, it offers infinite input impedance. An ideal operational amplifier offers infinite input impedance. So, infinite input impedance means it is, it does not take in any current, okay. Its input terminals do not sink any current into the device, okay. No current can flow into the device. That is what the meaning of this infinite input impedance, because you know that Ri is what? Ri equal to Vi upon, let us say Ri, Vi upon Ii, and since Ii is 0, then only we can get a Ri to be infinity, okay. So, these two terminals are not going to take any current. Whatever the current flowing in this resistor, that will take this path and it will completely go into this resistor R2, okay. If you utilize these two properties, the concept of virtual ground and that this device is not going to take any input current, you can analyze this circuit very easily. Okay. So, let me do this for you. As this terminal is grounded due to the virtual ground, here the potential has to be 0 volt, and if the potential of this node is known, I can find out the current passing through this resistor R1, because one of the terminal, one of the end of this resistor is at potential Vi. Okay. So, current passing here, let me call it I1. So, I1 passing through this resistor R1 is going to be Vi minus 0 divided by R1. Okay. This is the input current which is passing through this resistor R1. Okay, this resistor actually. R1 is the resistance value for this resistor. Okay. And as you know that this node is not going to take, I mean no current is going to flow into this operational amplifier. So, whatever the current I1 is, that will also pass through this R2. Okay. So, current through this resistor is also equal to Vi upon R1, okay, with the direction from left to right, okay, in this direction. Okay. And therefore, there will be a potential drop across that resistor, this resistor, and that potential drop is going to be R2 by R1 into Vi with this polarity. Is it or not? If current is flowing from left to right, this node will be at higher potential, this one will be at lower potential, and the potential drop is current Vi upon R1 into R2. So, the potential drop here is R2 upon R1 into Vi. Okay. Is it clear? Now, I can write the output voltage. How much output voltage will present in this case? V0. V0 is, can you tell me how much output voltage I will see here? This one is at 0 potential. So, let us start from this point. Okay. So, V0 equal to 0 and then move through this resistor. There is a potential drop here. So, I will write here minus R2 upon R1 into Vi. That is the potential drop in this resistor. Okay. So, V0 equal to 0 minus R2 upon R1 into Vi. Okay. Is it clear? And then I can rearrange the term. I can write here the gain for this amplifier, that is output voltage for divided by the input voltage, is equal to minus R2 upon R1. So, this is the voltage gain for an inverting amplifier. And inverting because of the fact that the output voltage is out of phase with the input voltage. Okay. That means, if the R2 is 5 kilo ohm, let us say R1 is 1 kilo ohm, so gain will be 5, and this, if this is the input signal here Ri, our output signal is going to be 180 degree phase shifted. So, it looks like this, where amplitude of this output signal is to be 5 times A. Okay. And there is a 180 degree phase shift between input and output signals. Okay. Is it clear? So, that is why this amplifier is called inverting amplifier, because of this minus sign, because of the phase shift of 180 degree between the output and input signals. Okay. Is it clear? So, one more important thing from an amplifier perspective, from an amplifier point of view, we always look at the input impedance for a voltage amplifier. Okay. As you know that the input impedance for a voltage amplifier should be very, very high, ideally it should be infinity. Okay. So, since we have designed a voltage amplifier here, let us investigate the input impedance for this voltage amplifier. Any one of you can tell me? What is the input resistance or input impedance? So, for this amplifier, the input is given here, is it or not? So, the resistance seen by this terminal of the voltage source, or the resistance seen by this voltage source, is called the input resistance for this amplifier. Okay? So, the resistance seen here, that means if you look into the circuit from this point, let us say that it is Ri. So, Ri has to be the input resistance for this amplifier. And what Ri is going to be in this case? R1 only. Why R1? You can see from intuition, because the another end is at 0. Okay? If you start from this point, you find a resistance R1, another terminal is grounded. Okay? So, there is no effect of this resistance or the input resistance of this amplifier onto this node. Therefore, the input impedance simply becomes R1 in this case. Okay? That you mathematically, you can also prove this mathematically, the input resistance Ri is R1. Okay? That we can very easily, we can prove that the input resistance Ri is the input voltage here divided by the current taken into, I mean the current drawn by this resistor. Okay. So, Ri, the input resistance is, the potential is Vi here, and the current drawn is again Vi divided by R1. So, it simply becomes R1. Okay. So, resistance, input resistance offered by this amplifier is only R1. Okay. Is it clear? So, but if you look at an ideal amplifier, you always go for high input resistance. Okay. So, to have a high input resistance, what you will do? You will have to increase this R1. Okay. But if you increase this R1, to maintain the gain, you also need to increase this R2. Okay. But the point is, how, I mean, what will be the maximum value for the R2? Okay. Practically, generally you do not take resistance greater than few mega ohm in the electronic circuit design. Okay. So, if you let us say that the 5 mega ohm is the maximum resistance which you can use in the circuit. Okay. So, in that case, if you need 5, if you want 5 voltage gain, of 5, then you have to use R1 to be 1 mega ohm. Okay. And that will be the limit for the input resistance in this case. Okay. What I want to tell you, that this amplifier is having one problem, and that problem is the input resistance is not infinite. Okay. Input resistance depends upon this input resistance R1. Okay. If you choose R1 too high, then you may suffer with the gain, you will get a very low gain. Okay. If you choose R1 very less, then you can have very high gain, but the input impedance suffer. Okay. So, you have to make a trade off between these two, either go for high voltage gain, low input resistance, or low input resistance with the high voltage gain. Okay. So, this problem is always there with inverting amplifier. However, this problem can be sorted out in case of inverting non-inverting amplifier. Okay, that I will show you later on. Okay. Any doubt? Is it clear? But remember that this analysis was done for an ideal operational amplifier. Okay. In a practical operational amplifier, if the gain A is finite, then in that case, the virtual short condition does not hold true. Okay. In that case, you will, if A is finite, you cannot write V2 equal to V1. Okay. Why? Because in that case, the V0 by A becomes equal to V2 minus V1. Okay. And even if you connect this terminal at the ground, okay. So, if you make V2 equal to 0, then in that case V1 becomes minus V0 by A, it does not goes to 0, okay. So, if you ground this circuit in non-ideal case, if I ground this, then this node will be at the 0 potential, but the potential here is actually becomes V1 equal to minus V0 by A, okay. And accordingly you can calculate the input current I1 in this case. What I1 is to be? I1 is Vi minus this potential, okay. So, Vi minus V0 by A divided by R1, okay. So, I1 is actually Vi, the input voltage, plus V0 by A upon R1, okay. And again, if you assume that the input current taken by this operational amplifier is 0, that means this, if this current flowing here is 0, then again I2 is will be almost equal to I1, and the potential V0 in this case can be written as, can you help me writing this equation? The V0, if it is a non-ideal case, you know the potential of this node, okay. So, let me write here the potential of this node, that is minus V0 upon A, okay, minus drop in this resistor. So, drop in this resistor is R2 into I1. So, it is minus R2 upon R1 into Vi plus V0 by A, okay. Is it clear? What I have done, I write this potential, then subtracted the potential drop in this resistor from this potential. So, here it is minus Vo by A, then minus the drop in this resistor, that is R2 upon R1 into Vi plus V0 by A, okay. Now, I can rearrange the term once again and can find out the voltage gain, okay. Now, the voltage gain is V0 upon, V0 is 1 plus 1 upon A into 1 plus R2 upon R1 equal to minus R2 by R1 into Vi, minus R2 upon R1 into Vi, the input voltage, okay. Just I have rearranged the terms here. And then I can write the voltage gain V0 equal to V0 upon Vi, which is also the closed loop gain for this amplifier, is minus R2 by R1 upon 1 plus 1 by A into 1 plus R2 by R1, okay. So, this is the closed loop gain of this amplifier if I consider the operational amplifier to be non-ideal, okay. If A is not infinity, if the open loop gain is not infinity, then we get this gain. Let me call it by G, okay. So, as it is very obvious, if A tending towards infinity in this equation, then this term becomes 0 and this equation reduces to that of the ideal case, In ideal case, we had voltage gain of minus R2 by R1. Okay. So, if A tending towards infinity in this equation, we get G equal to minus R2 by R1. Okay. So, this is a more general expression. It considers both the ideal and non-ideal case. Okay. But the input resistance even in this case is again R1. Is it clear? Okay. So, what you have concluded here, I mean you may conclude that by using these resistances R1 and R2, we have now managed the reasonable voltage gain. Okay. Earlier it was very high, of the order of of the order of 10 to the power 6 R infinity, but by connecting these resistances R2 and R1 in this fashion, we have got a reasonable gain of minus R2 upon R1, and if we choose R2 and R1 properly, we can have a gain of our choice. Okay. But one thing you should notice here, that now the gain of the amplifier, this overall amplifier, this inverting amplifier, it is function of the external resistances. Okay. I mean, if the resistance quality is not good, then in that case your gain may be a fluctuating one. If resistances, you see that a resistance of a resistor can change with the temperature, and if the environmental conditions are changing continuously, in that case this amplifier will offer you variable gain. Okay. This is not a good sign. Okay. But if you have a very good resistor of very stable resistance, which is less sensitive with the environmental condition, you are going to have a very good amplifier. Okay. With a and you are in a good position to control the gain, just either by changing R1 or R2, you can get a variable gain amplifier. If you have you can use a potentiometer in place of this resistor, you can change the resistance of that potentiometer and you can also get a variable gain. Okay. If you need 5, then you can get 5. If you want 10, then accordingly you can change either R1 or R2 to get the different gain. You need not to design another amplifier or change the setup for that another amplification factor. Okay, this is the good thing. But still this amplifier suffers with a problem of low input resistance. Okay, that is the disadvantage of this amplifier. Okay. So, one thing I had forgotten to tell you, this name operational amplifier is because of a specific reason. We call it operational amplifier. It is because we can perform many mathematical functions. Okay, like you can take logarithm of a voltage signal, you can get anti-logarithmic, you can implement integrator, differentiator. Okay. You can perform so many mathematical operations, that is why this device is called operational amplifier. It performs mathematical function. Okay. For example, if you want to design a weighted summer, okay. Weighted summer means, let us say that we have two inputs V1 and V2, okay. And we want to design a function in this manner, V0 equal to A time V1 plus B time V2. Okay. We can do this with the help of operational amplifier. This is the weighted sum of V1 and V2. V1 is weighted by A and V2 is weighted by B. So, I can get V0 equal to, using operational amplifier, I can get V0, I can implement this function very easily. Okay. And for this purpose, I can use this inverting amplifier. Okay. How can I do that? Let me show you. I have to implement this kind of function, or even you can implement, you can extend it to n number of input signal. Okay. Let me write it a1 a2 plus an vn. Okay. I can use that inverting amplifier in this fashion, minus plus, the plus is grounded with minus. I can have a resistance here R1 connecting to this input terminal and another one, let us say that R2, and finally here Rn with the inputs V1, V2 and Vn. Okay. And a feedback resistance here that is called R1 with the output V0. Okay. Can you find V0 in term of V1, V2 and Vn? It is very easy to do. Okay. Here I would like to tell you one important thing. We become able to reduce the gain of this operational amplifier from very high value to low value because of this resistance R1. Okay. This resistance is called feedback resistance. Okay. The operational amplifier is connected in a negative feedback manner. Okay. That means the sum portion of the output voltage is given back to the input terminal here, the inverting terminal here. Okay. Just look at the simple example, minus plus, this plus is grounded, you see this is our R2, if it is R1, R2. And I apply here V1 or VI, it is V0. Okay. Then what I want to tell you, forget about this operational amplifier. Okay. If I forget about this operational amplifier, then what I see, there is a in one voltage here VI and another voltage at the another terminal, that is V0. Okay. Why I have forgotten? It is because of this operational amplifier is not going to take any current. Okay. So, since it is not taking any current, then I can forget about this node. Okay. But you cannot forget about this in practice. If you remove this, then this thing will not happen. Okay. So, if you forget about this operational amplifier, what you see, that two resistances connected in series R1 and R2, one in at V1 potential, VI potential, another one at the V0 potential. So, in that case, if you calculate the potential of this node, what you find? You find this is actually Vi into R2 upon R1 plus R2 plus this V plus V0 into R1 upon R1 plus R2. Okay. The potential at this node is sum of the two potentials which are separately contributed by the potential Vi and potential V0. Okay. So, the summary of this is actually what we do, we take a portion of the output voltage and that portion of the output voltage is given back to the inverting terminal here. Okay. And because of this thing, actually the gain drops to a very low value. Okay. We have some sort of negative feedback mechanism here. Okay. Is it clear or not? Had I done this connection R2 at this node, okay, this concept, I mean this drop in gain would have not been possible. Getting my point? If I simply connect this R2 rather than connecting to inverting node, if I do this like this, then what you will see? That this circuit becomes unstable. Why it is so? Because now here a fraction of V naught appears, okay, and that fraction is given to the positive node of the output. You know that V naught is equal to A times V 2 minus V 1, okay. So, if a fraction of output is given back to input, means you are increasing this part. So, increasing this part means V naught is again increased, and since V naught again increased, that increased V naught will contribute more potential at this node. So, this V 2 will keep increasing, and as a result V naught will also keep increasing, and finally, this circuit becomes unstable, okay. So, negative feedback is a good thing to control the gain of the amplifier, okay. With positive feedback, we can implement circuits like oscillator, which are actually used as a signal source, okay. We cannot use the positive feedback in case of an amplifier, okay. So, this gain reduction was possible because of this feedback resistance R2, okay. Now, you can do this, you can find out V naught in term of V 1, V 2 and V n. It is very easy to do, you can very easily do this. Okay. So, again I assume that this one to be an ideal amplifier. So, since this one is at 0 potential, inverting terminal, non-inverting terminal, its inverting terminal will also be at 0 potential. And since it is at 0 potential, the current passing through this resistor is V n upon R 1, passing through this one is R n, passing through this one is V 2 upon R 2, passing through this one is V 1 upon R 1. So, I have a current in at this node. This current, if it is I 1, this one is I 2 and this one is I n. So, current leaving this node, if it is I, then I can write Kirchhoff's law at this node, and I can write that I equal to I 1 plus I 2 plus I n. Could I do this? Okay. All incoming current is equal to, I mean, summation of the all incoming currents is equal to the outgoing current I, okay. And what is I 1? I 1 is simply V 1 upon R 1 plus V 2 upon R 2 plus V n upon R n, okay. And you can now write down the V naught. V naught is the potential here 0 minus I into R 1, okay. So, V naught becomes 0 minus, oh, this is better write here R f, feedback resistance, okay. So, V naught now becomes minus R f upon R 1 into V 1 minus R f upon R 2 into V 2 plus minus R f upon R n into V n, okay. And let us say that this R f upon R 1 is our weight factor A 1, R f upon R 2 is weight factor A 2, then I can say that V naught equal to minus A into V 1 minus A 1 into V 1, A 2 into V 2 minus A n into V n. Okay. Thus, we have got this kind of input-output relationship. The only difference you note is a negative sign present, okay. And how can I neglect this negative sign? I mean, what can I do for this negative sign? How can I remove this? I can design one more inverting amplifier with a unity gain. Is it or not? If I cascade this amplifier with another amplifier here, which has the input resistance R and the feedback resistance again R, okay, then my V naught is actually now becomes V naught equal to A1 V1 plus A2 V2 plus An Vn and so on. Is it clear or not? Okay. This second stays because both resistances are equal, it offers a gain of minus R upon R, that is minus 1. Okay. And if two voltage amplifiers are connected in series, then their gains multiplied. Okay. Their gains get multiplied. That means if I have a amplifier with gain A1, another amplifier with gain A2, then the overall gain becomes A1 into A2, simply multiplied. Okay. If you represent a gain in decibel, then it gets added. That means if the first amplifier offers 20 dB voltage gain, second one 20 dB voltage gain, then overall gain becomes 40 dB. But if you write absolute gain, it simply gets multiplied. So, because of the minus 1 gain of this stage, the minus sign which is present here now can be eliminated. Okay. And thus we can design a weighted sum adder, you can say, a weighted sum adder. This circuit is generally called by this name. Okay. So, let us stop here today. In next class, we shall talk about the non-inverting, inverting amplifier. Okay.